Hello friends, good morning again and welcome back to Centum Academy. Last class friends, we have discussed about the acidic nature of phenol and we have also seen few problems into that. To write down the order of acidity of various derivative of phenols, right? Various phenol molecules. One more very important order we have, which is the boiling point order of nitrophenol. Okay, so we'll see the boiling point order of nitrophenol. Nitrophenol will have ortho para and meta nitrophenol. For example, you see this is OH and OH and NO2 at ortho position. It is ortho nitrophenol. This one meta nitrophenol. OH and NO2. This is para nitrophenol. Okay, so the boiling point order of ortho para and meta nitrophenol we have here. You see what happens in case of ortho nitrophenol, which is nothing but if I write down the molecule, I'll just do the one small change here. I'll write down in this way. O minus double bond O and positive charge on nitrogen. Similarly, we have O minus double bond O and positive charge on nitrogen. Then we have O minus double bond O and positive charge on nitrogen. So this is ortho nitro, ortho para meta nitrophenol. So in case of ortho nitrophenol, what happens, we'll have intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, OH and this O minus, this is, we have intramolecular hydrogen bonding possible. In ortho nitrophenol, we have intramolecular hydrogen bonding. And here we have intermolecular hydrogen bonding possible. How it is there, that you see, if I draw the another molecule of phenol like this, suppose we have the another molecule like this, we are drawing. And O2 here and OH here, right? So in para nitrophenol, we have intermolecular hydrogen bonding. This you see, this is what intermolecular hydrogen bonding possible. Intermolecular hydrogen bonding, because this NO2 and OH group present in the molecule is not close enough, and hence the intramolecular hydrogen bonding is not possible. Now, because of intramolecular hydrogen bonding, boiling point decreases, and intermolecular hydrogen bonding, boiling point increases. Okay, boiling point decreases and boiling point increases, and hence the order of boiling point of nitrophenol is maximum for para nitrophenol, maximum for para, and then we have meta nitrophenol, meta nitrophenol, and in the last we have ortho nitrophenol, right? So order is this PMO, you have to memorize for this one. This is the order we have of boiling point, that is PMO, para nitro meta nitro ortho nitro. Okay, right? So what happens due to presence of very stable resonating structure in para nitrophenol, it gains significant dipolar character and develops a very strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding. That is the intermolecular force of attraction. That's why it has maximum boiling point. This intermolecular hydrogen bonding is strong in comparison to intramolecular hydrogen bonding. That's why the order is this. Okay. The similar reason we have for the order of solubility. Solubility order is also same, which is nothing but this. Para is maximum, then meta, and then nitro, right? Then ortho, right? The reason is also same. So this is an important comparison we have. Boiling point, order of nitrophenol. They ask this question many times in various competitive exams. So acidity we have discussed, boiling point we have discussed. Now the next thing we have to understand here is the method of preparation of phenol. Okay. So the next thing is method of preparation. Okay. The first method we have from aryl sulfonic acid. From aryl sulfonic acid. What happens with aryl sulfonic acid, you see, aryl sulfonic acid is nothing but this molecule, benzene ring and SO3H present on the ring. When this is heated with NaOH H2O, then it forms the sodium salt of this acid, which is SO3Na, which is again fused with NaOH. Two molecules of NaOH we are taking, fusion takes place and it converts into Na2CO3 and ONa here, Na2SO3 and ONa here. Plus Na2SO3. This is when heated with HCl acid forms NaCl and we get phenol as one of the product, OH plus NaCl. This is the preparation of phenol from aryl sulfonic acid. Right? Aryl sulfonic acid is nothing but this molecule. Aryl sulfonic acid. Okay. Now the next method of preparation. Next method of preparation we have from diazonium salt. From diazonium salt. Diazonium salt we can take benzene diazonium chloride or benzene diazonium bisulfate. Diazonium salt we can take here, either we can take benzene diazonium chloride or we can also take bisulfate. You see this reaction, benzene diazonium bisulfate is nothing but this molecule, N2 plus H SO4 minus. When it is heated with water, N2 molecules goes out, we get OH plus N2 plus H2SO4. This H plus from water takes this HSO4 minus, forms H2SO4. NO2 molecules goes out and then OH minus attached on the ring. Okay. This process is known as steam distillation. This method is steam distillation. These are the direct reaction we have. You need to know what product we get under this reaction. Okay. Generally, the reaction which involves diazonium salt, N2 gas always evolves into that. Always comes out. Correct. So this is the reaction we have. If you take N2 by benzene disonium chloride, which is N2 plus Cl minus, then we'll get HCl here. Instead of H2SO4, we'll get HCl. Okay. The next method of preparation we have is third one. Reaction of phenolic ester with soda lime. Phenolic acid with soda lime. The process is known as distillation. This process is distillation process. Phenolic acid is this OHCOOH. This is phenolic acid. When it is heated with soda lime is a mixture of NaOH with CaO. When you heat this with this mixture, first it forms sodium phenoxide, which is ONA, plus Na2CO3 goes out. And when it is hydrolyzed, acidic hydrolysis, it converts into phenol and NaOH. Okay, this is the reaction we have. Na2CO3 forms here. One of the product of this is Na2CO3. And here we have NaOH, excess of NaOH we are taking here. Right? We can also prepare phenol by catalytic oxidation. Okay, like from toluene. We can also prepare phenol from toluene, and it's again a direct reaction. And in this, the toluene is heated with oxygen molecule in presence of a catalyst. Okay, in presence of a catalyst. Okay, so you see the reaction. The toluene is this molecule, benzene with CH3 on the top. And when it is heated with oxygen molecule in presence of a catalyst like magnesium or copper sulfate, MnSO4 or CuSO4, this converts into OH. This is catalytic oxidation. Okay. So these are the reactions we have through which we can prepare phenol. One more very important reaction we have, that is cumene phenol process. Okay. The production of phenol from cumene. Okay. I'll write down this in the next page. And the last method of preparation we have here is cumene phenol process. Okay. That is the fifth one. Cumene phenol process. This reaction is a bit important among the all that we did so far. Okay, now in this process, what happens? In this process, I'll write down first the theory we have here. In this process, cumene is oxidized in O2. In O2, in alkaline medium, and forms cumene hydroperoxide. peroxide forms in this step. Cumene, hydroperoxide, which is then decomposed by H2SO4 acidic medium H2SO4 into phenol. This is the whole process we have. Okay, first that oxidation in O2 in alkaline medium forms hydroperoxide, and then decomposition with acid, that is H2SO4. You see the reaction here is what? Cumene is nothing but we have a benzene ring, and on this benzene ring isopropyl group is attached, CH, CH3 and CH3. This is cumene. Okay, when the reaction takes place with O2 in the first step, we have in alkaline medium OH minus, and in the second step, we have acid H2SO4. So the product we get here, first of all, I'll write down the product. The product is phenol, PHOH, and we'll get acetone in this. Phenol and acetone we get, CH3O, CH3. Okay. How the reaction proceeds, you see, first of all, when this cumene, when the cumene is heated with oxygen in alkaline medium, it forms cumene hydroperoxide, which is nothing but pH, CCH3, CH3, OOH. This is cumene hydroperoxide. Cumene hydroperoxide. Now in acidic medium, what happens? H plus, we have the oxygen here protonates in acidic medium. This oxygen, which has lone pair on it, this protonates in acidic medium, and it forms this one, which is PHC, CH3, CH3, oxygen, oxygen, H, H, positive charge on it. Okay. Finally, in the next step, the phenyl ion, this takes this bond pair of electron, and it rearranges itself onto this oxygen, and this H2O goes out. Okay, so the product here we get is PHOCCH3, CH3, positive charge on this carbon plus H2O. Okay. And when you have H plus H2O here, sorry, H2O, this H2O behaves as a nucleophile, attacks onto this positive charged carbon atom. Okay. And it forms PHO. C, CH3, CH3, O, H2, positive charge. Now from this, H plus comes out, one of this H plus comes out, deprotonation, minus of H plus. So H plus comes out, and it forms PH O C OH CH3 and CH3. Okay. Now this lone pair of oxygen again protonates in the next step and it forms PH OH positive charge on it C OH CH3 and CH3. Right? Now to stabilize this positive charge on oxygen, this pH OH positive charge CCH3 OH CH3. This bond breaks and will get phenol. This takes this bond pair of electron, comes out as pH OH. Plus the molecule left here is CH3 CCH3 OH and positive charge on this carbon because this bond pair is taken up by the oxygen. Finally H plus comes out into this, deprotonation takes place and it forms CH3 C double bond O CH3 and H plus goes out. Okay. So this is the mechanism of this reaction. So overall we'll get phenol and acetone in this reaction. So cumene under oxidation, right, and then acidic hydrolysis, H2SO4 we use for that purpose, H2SO4 and H2O, it forms phenol and acetone. This is again the preparation method of phenol from cumene. This reaction is important among all the reaction that we did so far for the preparation of phenol. Okay.